Hiya, welcome to Gorilla Physio. I have got a treat for you today. This is Mr. Bonser, and he's sent me a demo. And
for this experiment, so you'll need an old filament lamp, a strong magnet, a red screen to save your eyes, and if we turn on the lamp, you'll see why we need the red screen. So pop the red screen in front, zoom in, then hold the magnet next to the filaments, and you should see some clear vibrations at 50 hertz.
50 hertz.
This is the motor effect on a filament light bulb.
Wow, what a great demo. So that's the motor effect on a filament light bulb. Why is it vibrating? Well, it mains electricity in the UK is 50 hertz AC. That means it changes direction 50 times every second. So the motor effect, we use this, the Fermi's left-hand rule. You remember this is the force, so this is like the motion of the wire, if you like. This is the first thing, that's the magnetic field. That's the magnet that is holding against the bulb. And then this is the direction of the current. Now, if the current changes direction every, 50 times every second, if the current changes direction 50 times every second, then the force changes direction 50 times every second as well. So you get that vibration. So here it is in slow motion as well. I mean, it's just absolutely epic, isn't it? So that's a filament bulb, and there's loads of other physics that you need to know as well, which is, well, why does a filament bulb work in the first place? It's a great demonstration of that current causes heating, and then, well, the filament gets hot, and therefore it glows. That's how a filament bulb works. Essentially, if you can imagine all the electrons traveling through that wire, they're going to bump into the atoms of the metal, and that's going to cause vibrations, and therefore that's going to cause heating, and hot things glow. And you need to know quite a bit about filament bulbs, really. You need to know the VI characteristic graph, and that's here, and how that's different from an ohmic resistor as well. Also, did you see that Mr. Bonser used colour filters? So he actually used a colour filter, and that allows only one colour to be transmitted through it. It absorbs all the other colours of light. Now, if he didn't use that, then it would just be too bright for us to see that on the camera. That's absolutely awesome. Let me know if you like this type of video. I'm going to ask Mr. Bonser to do some more demos for us here on YouTube. So go over to Twitter and follow Mr. Bonser as well. That's at BonserMister, and there's loads and loads and loads of demos on there. I really love following his things. They're some of the best things on Twitter. Let me know if you like this type of video, and we can do more of them. This has been Gorilla Physics. Thank you very much. I'm Kit Best Masters. Don't forget to subscribe and check out this playlist with loads of other details on magnetism, electricity, and magnetism.